scientist. Yes, of course I remember you. Yay! I'm here to help you feel a little less stuck at home.
Uh-huh.
Are you ready?
Yeah, I'm ready.
So I have some stuff to show you today.
Uh-huh.
Some of it looks like this.
Whoa.
Maybe I can bring this one.
Whoa.
And check out before and after.
Before. You look all funky.
I do look a little funky. Yeah, so this is a lens, and maybe you've seen some people wearing lenses, and it looks more like that.
Oh, those are, humans call them glasses,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah. So I actually also wear glasses, and my glasses have lenses, and those lenses help me see better. I have a hard time reading up close, so I need lenses to help me out.
Oh.
But you might have also seen lenses and things that look like this.
Yeah, that's a telescope. I have a telescope at home, Evelyn. Did you know that?
I did not. So tell me, what do you use your telescope for?
Yeah, I use my telescope to look up at the night sky.
That...
But my telescope doesn't have lenses. It has mirrors.
Oh, that is super cool. So I use my telescope to look at birds. So I like a telescope, but... Wait, did you just say your telescope has mirrors?
Mm-hmm.
Wow, those are really, really nice telescopes.
It's a very nice telescope.
Maybe one day you can show me what you look at with
sure.
your telescope. So my telescopes are a little different. They're very simple. So we use some paper towel rolls and
uh-huh.
some old lenses. And that lens lets the light go through it. And as it goes through that special shape it has, it bends the light in a way. Well, it'll make things look bigger or smaller. Now, we can combine a few different lenses and play around with them to make things look bigger or smaller.
Whoa, that's so cool!
Yeah, I don't want to bore you too much. Do you want to tell us anything else about your telescope?
Well, my telescope, I mentioned I like to look at the night sky using it, and I like to look at the moon and the planets, and the mirrors inside reflect light. And my mirror is actually curved, Evelyn.
You
can tell me about how
Yeah! Oh my gosh, that's right. So mirrors and the lenses that you'll find inside of the telescope, like I said, will have a very special shape. And sometimes it's a combination of shapes, but usually you'll see a lens that curves in on each side. And we like to call that concave. And that
you... Because it caves in!
Yeah!
That's so cool! Because
it caves in. Now this other one is a little harder to remember. It's not as easy. This... Well, one actually, the shape goes out.
So it's called con out?
It is not. It is called convex. I wish it was called con out.
Yeah.
That would have helped me in my exams.
I know. But why do humans have to make it so complicated?
I don't know, but I will say, humans have a lens that has this shape inside of their eye.
Whoa.
And the really funny thing about this shape is that usually when the light goes through it, it ends up making things look upside down. I know. I mean, you look at the night sky. When you look up at the planets or the moon, does it matter if they're upside down or not upside down? No.
Actually, I've never really thought about it. Hello, Evelyn, are you back?
Oh,
Evelyn, are you back?
Yep, sorry.
Yeah.
Did I freeze?
Yeah, you did.
Yeah.
You were frozen for a very long time.
Sorry, reception has been a little bad today. Okay,
okay.
Now that I'm back and that you can see me, like we were saying, some telescopes have mirrors inside of them with very special shapes to give us some amazing pictures. And more simple telescopes have lenses and combine different lens shapes to also do that same thing, give us these beautiful pictures. Now, when you're looking up into the sky, we have this amazing thing all around us that most of us need to breathe to stay alive. So we need that air. And sometimes that causes things to not look as great. Which is why scientists started making space telescopes. I know, it sounds like it's not true, but you can think of Hubble as a space telescope. You can look that one up, and that telescope doesn't have to deal with all of that extra air in the way, so then we get some really, really amazing pictures.
Like the one behind you?
Yeah, like this one behind me. That's why I wanted to show you this one too, because it is really, really great. Now, I see somebody calling me, which means I have to go, so I'm so sorry, but I hope you're feeling a little less stuck at home.
I am, Evelyn.
Hey,
thank you.
Next time, you need to show me what you do with your telescope, and maybe you can tell me about some of the things that we can find in the night sky.
Yeah, I'd be happy to do so.
Bye.
Bye, Evelyn. See you next time.
Be sure to visit our website Monday through Friday at 10 a.m. for more stuck-at-home science activities.